of art. In the arts we do believe. Creative art. Through the arts we will achieve. Life is full of opportunities. With the help of our students and teachers, I know you will.
Greetings to all the graduates of the class of 2020 of the City of Camden. Mayor Frank Moran here. Just wanted to congratulate you on this accomplishment and many accomplishments to come. Education is a key to success. Please go out, get your degrees, and come back to the City of Camden and continue to contribute to the city that's rising, your city, Camden, New Jersey.
Perseverance, grit, determination, focus, hard work, tenacity, dedication, persistence, and more. You have all exhibited some, if not all, these qualities to make it to the culmination of your high school senior year. While in-person graduation ceremonies for the class of 2020 have come to a halt to protect the health and well-being of our communities, this doesn't detract from your outstanding accomplishments thus far. As the leaders of tomorrow, you set the tone for what our future will be starting today. This year has brought some unexpected interruptions in your plans, and you may be filled with uncertainty. Please know that we are all working through these tough times together and are confident we will emerge stronger than ever after this. Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. once said, "If you can't fly, then run. If you can't run, then walk. If you can't walk, then crawl. But whatever you do, you have to keep moving forward." This quote is particularly important for you as you embark on uncharted journeys. I am confident that you will accomplish amazing things and become outstanding, upstanding members of society, propelling our state, nation, and the entire world to new heights. Class of 2020, you will be great. While we can't celebrate you in person with a traditional ceremony, please know that the governor and the entire state of New Jersey stand proud and salute you. Congratulations.
To the class of 2020 of the Camden City School District. I am so proud of the class of 2020, as well as the teachers, coaches, and families who have guided you along the way. This school year presented many challenges, and you have overcome each and every one of them with style and grace. As a district, we have overcome so much this year. If you recall, in November, we witnessed and survived a violent act during the Camden-Pleasantville football game. During these moments of fear, we protected one another, and several students and staff emerged as heroes. We experienced the disappointing end to our Camden High basketball season, and the realization many seniors would not complete their final season of spring sports in any of our Camden high schools. We lost our beloved school board president of over 20 years, Mrs. Martha F. Wilson. We are still experiencing a global pandemic that derailed our normal school schedules, prom, and other celebratory milestones. And the recent murder of George Floyd shook many of us to our very cores. It also caused us to rise up, to listen to one another across racial lines, and to protect one another. Individually, you have all persevered through your own obstacles. Every time you emerge stronger and better than before. For every obstacle we faced, we still have much to celebrate. And some of those points of celebration are: our graduation rate continues to rise. The fact that many of you received scholarships for academics and sports to attend your first choice schools shows that you continue to rise. Despite obstacles, Tiger Nation roared back as Woodrow Wilson High School brought home a football state championship win. You continue to rise. Despite our world being turned upside down, you all remained focused. You all rose above the challenges and emerged as the brilliant leaders we knew you were. While I can't begin to imagine all of the emotions you have experienced over the past months, I want to take this time to assure you that the disappointment of not being able to celebrate in person today will pass, and the emotions and memories that will remain will be ones of joy, resilience, and empowerment. Graduation is a monumental achievement under any circumstances. Graduating this year is really special. This graduating class is a part of so much history. All of your experiences have helped you grow up faster than some generations and have prepared you to conquer future obstacles. There is so much power that rests in your hands, and I know that you will use it to help each other, to help your family, and to help the community continue to rise. I am proud of you all and can't wait to see and hear what you accomplish in the next chapter of your lives. So congratulations to the class of 2020 of the Camden City School District. Keep making yourselves proud, keep making your families proud, and keep making the city of Camden proud. Congratulations, you've earned this special day.
Greetings, I'm your brother, Brother Minister Wasim Muhammad, School Board President of the Camden City School District. I want to first say congratulations to the class of 2020. I want to let you know how proud I am of you and all of the graduates here this year upon a very, very exciting and different year, you know, where most of our young people's education was kind of interrupted by, you know, the pandemic and some of the uprisings that we see going around the country dealing with systemic racism. But you are the highlight of the year. You are graduating and about to enter into the world. And we are so proud of you that you can accomplish and still succeed amongst anything that happens to you, that you can keep going on. So that is a moment in time that you will never forget. And I know what the Creator has put in you has made you able to succeed. So when you do continue to succeed, come back to your city and make your city a clean and safe place to live. Congratulations.
Hi, Clamber Class of 2020. It's great to be here today with you and your families. Congratulations. Congratulations on the milestone that you have achieved today. I want you to continue to achieve those milestones. I know that your school year was cut short a bit because of the pandemic. You did not get to do some of the normal things, as you didn't have your prom, class trip, and some of the other things, but I know you can handle that bump in your road because you are resilient. Many of you are leaders. You are already community leaders. You are leaders in your churches and in other areas. So continue to just be that leader. Continue to be confident in your skills. Know that you have special gifts and talents that only you have. Be confident in those gifts and talents. Use those gifts and talents to make a difference in someone else's life. I am so proud of the colleges and universities that you've been accepted to and all of the scholarships that you have been afforded. all of that means that for the 12 years that you've been in school, you have worked very hard. I have watched some of you grow from 11 years old till today. So again, I am so proud to see the young men and young women who are graduating from our school today. So just continue to stay encouraged. Continue to stay close to your families. Be thoughtful. And never, ever think that you are not good enough. Because always remember, you are, and if you put your mind to it, you can do anything. And remember, you will achieve greatness because you already have. Good luck. Continue the fight. Continue to be strong. And again, congratulations to the Creative Arts Morgan Villages class of 2020.
Good morning, Dr. Brockington, teachers, parents, students, and class of 2020. Today we are gathered here to celebrate your success in high school. Mr. Bogart and I have had a wonderful experience knowing you first as our students in our classes and later being your class advisor. I have known some of you from your middle school years, Ashanti, Shanice, Tassam, Zaria, Lanesia, Laquaya, Crystal, Zainab, to mention a few of you. It was a pleasure working with you as a teacher. I enjoyed you in my seventh grade class where we made edible volcanoes. We also made mind maps. We wrote books on Story Jumper. Maria, I still remember your book on hygiene and Caillou, my dog. We had a wonderful time having science experiments and flame tests.
As I reflect, Ayesha, Zainab, and Tochi, since your freshman year, you two were always there for every water ice sale and fundraiser we had up through your senior year. We could always depend on your selfless support and class spirit. You really taught us all about giving of oneself.
To some, Kyara and Zaria, I always thought of you as the three musketeers. You always came to me about the prom, the Met Gala, so much so we decided to have a red carpet in Greek style.
We also like to acknowledge Ampara, Lanesia, Maria, Natalia, Tay, Tyon, Nayana, Ashanti, and Caleb for all your contributions, whether it was helping with fundraisers or providing leadership for your classmates, or for being there providing emotional support to those who really needed it. We are proud and grateful for you all for what you have done.
The Fine Art Department, Tochi, Anparo, Sophia, Imani, we are really proud of your contribution to the fine arts. Sophia, you participated in the Woodmere Art Museum twice. Anparo, you won gold at ATSO. We would also like to commend the senior dancers, Lanesia, Daliana, Kalima, Tassan, and Zaria. You did a phenomenal job at the Black Dance Conference in Philadelphia. Not only are you talented, but you presented yourself positively and represented CAMVA well.
For all those seniors we did not mention, but contributed nonetheless, Mr. Stein, I thank you both. Class of 2020, you'll always be remembered as the class that graduated during the pandemic. You are truly unique. Thank you for enriching our lives, as you all have touched us and left us with something to remember you by. Go ahead and celebrate your accomplishments and strive for excellence. Thank you for your experiences and allowing us to grow with you. Congratulations, class of 2020. Mrs. Tsai and I wish you all the best in your future as you spread your wings and start a new chapter in your lives. And remember, as Michelle Obama once said, quote, "You should never view your challenges as a disadvantage. Instead, it is important for you to understand that your experience facing and overcoming adversity, especially during these difficult times, is actually one of your greatest advantage."
Hello everyone, my name is Imani, your 2020 salutatorian, and thank you all that are here to celebrate and support the graduating class of 2020, as well as all of our accomplishments and future endeavors. You have all impacted us students so greatly and have invested in us through our entire time at Creative Arts. I personally like to thank God, my mom, family, friends, teacher, staff, and all those who rooted for me, as you each in some way helped shape and guide me to become the person I am today, and also helping me aim for a great future that I have set ahead for myself. When I first came to Creative Arts, my seventh grade year, I can admit that I was a little girl that did not know her potential, who kept herself in a box and tried to live up to other standards instead of living up to her own. But that changed once I came to Creative Arts. This school was the environment I never knew I needed, as it pushed me to be better and meet wonderful people, in which I'm sure most of you can see eye to eye with that. I remember my first year at Creative Arts, we had this kickball tournament, and me being me trying to branch out, I participated. Once I went back to class the afternoon, when it was over, I cried, like literally bawled my eyes out. To this day, I have no idea why I cried. I cannot remember. It may have been because I lost and the other team was bragging. It's quite embarrassing when I look back on it. But one thing I do recall is that the teacher whose class I was crying in didn't push me away or yell at me because I was crying. They took me to another room, handed me some tissues, talked to me, and gave me a pep talk about how I shouldn't let failures or others affect me, my optimism, and or my confidence. I took that advice and ran with it. And when I look back on those past years, I think about the good times and the amount of times I pushed myself to be better. I even think about the more challenging times. But each memory I have stored, each has something amazing that I took out of it, and is one of the many reasons I am here today telling you all this. That same teacher has numerously informed me of the quote they once learned, "To be good is not enough when you dream of being great." To my fellow 2020 graduates, I am not one to tell you what to do with your life and your future, and I am sure you have already heard what I'm about to tell you. However, on that note, I'd like to reassure you that your failures, mistakes, and setbacks does not define who you are, and there are always going to be people who don't think you are good enough and say that they are better than you for any reason, but do not believe them. I can assure you of this, as I've had my fair share of humbling experiences, such as me completely losing myself freshman year, losing track of the days I ate, doubting myself, and having a lack of motivation. Yes, I still struggle to this day, but I manage to get up every day, strive to be a better person than I was the day before, and get one step closer to where I want to be in life, and so can you. I'm sure each of you have had a bad experience or feeling, no matter how big or small. Just promise me that you will never let anything, anyone, or your own negative thoughts strip you of your success and opportunities, and to never settle down as any less than what you deserve, when you can become 10 times better. Each and every one of you have potential to be something great. We have been through so much and have come so far to just rest and give up. You know it, I know it, we all know it. You just need to accept it. I am proud of each and every one of you. Thank you for making these past years amazing. I would truly miss you, and I wish you all the best of luck.
Hey, Arnetta Johnson here, alumni, class of 2012. Sheesh. I'm coming here to celebrate you all. This is a big deal. This is such a big deal. Super proud of you all. You all have succeeded at such a high limit, and you know, you're just walking out with greatness. You know, a lot of times you hear walking into greatness. Yo, y'all are walking out with greatness on your shoulders. Y'all literally pushed through and persevered. Y'all did something none of us have done before. That's greatness, and that just shows that the sky's the limit. You can do whatever you want to do. Don't let anybody tell you that you can't. So I encourage you all to continue to study. Continue to go hard with whatever passion that you have. Go hard, go hard, go hard. Do not limit yourself. Don't let anybody limit you. Because look, look where you are right now. You pushed through all four of those years. You pushed through now. These crazy times. That's, y'all are tough. Y'all are tough. And don't take that lightly. So again, congratulations to the class of 2020. Y'all are dope. Again, y'all some tough cookies, man. Y'all are tough. All right, congratulations and keep on being great. All right.
On the first day of school in the sixth grade, my mom told me that I had to take the bus to school. Because I had never taken the bus before by myself, I was optimistic but nervous. My older sister walked me to the bus stop, and when the bus arrived, I got on the 400. But what I didn't know was that I was going in the wrong direction. When I finally noticed that the surroundings looked nothing like Fairview, I turned to the right of me and asked another passenger, was this bus going to Creative Arts? She then started telling me how this bus was going to Philadelphia and to get off as soon as I could. Other people on the bus began telling me which buses to take, but it all just sounded like numbers to me. I had no idea what they were talking about. I decided I was going to get on the 450 because that's what most people in the bus had suggested. At this point, I was feeling more than nervous. I was feeling scared. When the 450 arrived, I thought I was finally set. I sat on the bus feeling very anxious. A stop was coming up that I thought someone said was the street that Creative Arts was on. When I stepped off the bus, all I saw was an empty lot and construction. I looked right and left and I didn't see anything. At this point, all I wanted to do was cry. I felt so lost and scared, but I didn't panic and I didn't cry despite the huge lump in my throat, and I stepped back on the bus. The bus driver asked me where I was going and I told him Creative Arts. From there, I made it, a little late, but in one piece. The moment I walked through those doors, any feeling of worry washed away. I've always been proud of myself and how things turned out that day. I kept it together in the midst of the unknown. I was able to stay strong even though nothing was going my way. That day, I took a leap of faith. I only had 2 bus tickets, and I had no idea how I was getting home because of the mistakes that I made. But I wasn't worried, and I made it home. I always tried to keep that energy of the 6th grade experience with me during all my years at Creative Arts and outside of it. It's easy to give up and feel nothing, but it's hard to keep going and feel everything. That day was just the start of my journey to discovering who I am at this school. So many aspects of this school have played a part in who I am now, but the biggest has to be dance. For several years, I had a love-hate relationship with my craft. When I first came to Creative Arts, I wanted nothing more than to dance, but as the years passed by, my passion quickly dwindled because of the environment. I quickly grew tired of being laughed at and talked about when I was trying my best. I used to dread going to class, and when 8th grade came, I had this strong urge to change my major. To this day, I'm not sure what made me stay, but it's one of the best decisions I've made in my life. As a result, I started high school with the mindset that I didn't care who said anything about me because I was in that room to better myself. Miss Holiday used to say, dance is 1% physical and 99% mental, and it wasn't long before I realized that this would apply to more than just dance. When I finally stopped caring what others thought is when I finally saw growth within myself and my abilities. I can honestly say that being a dance major made me so self-assured and content within myself. Now every time I step into a room, I know who and what I'm there for. For me and many others in this room, this won't be the first or last time we receive criticism and doubt. When we leave this school today, there will be people who judge us, people who try to silence us, and people who count us out before we've even started. But what will you do with that criticism? How will you grow and show those who count you out that you're not yet done? To me, the answer is simple. The key is to keep pushing and making way, even when you're laughed at, even when you're last to get picked, and even when you want nothing more in the world than to give up. Had I changed my major, not only would I be somewhere where I had no passion, but I wouldn't be able to stand before you today and tell my truth. I think we all can agree that this school changed us for the better. I came to Creative Arts a shy, smart, sensitive, and quiet girl, but I'm leaving an independent, smarter, outspoken, and ambitious young woman. You see, some things never change. We all came here with a sparkle in our eye thinking that this would be Hollywood Arts, but what we found was something better. We found a community, a family, mentors, supporters, and our best friends for this lifetime and the next. It wasn't the TV show we wanted, but it was the reality that we needed. Finally, I'll leave you with this thought. There could be 100 people in the room and 99 of them don't believe in you, but all it takes is one who does. Miss Holiday, Miss McBride, Miss Wagner Lynch, Mr. Edwards, Mr. Jones, Mr. Pfeffer, Mr. Klein, and Mr. Wiseman was my one. And I'll be yours. Thank you.
Congratulations to the class of 2020. My name is Lamar Baylor, and I am an alumnus of the Creative Arts High School graduating class of 2004. I know the ending of your year was not the most ideal. However, this year has demonstrated your class's uniqueness, nerve, and resilience, and will be known as one of the most transformative years in history. You all have endured and experienced an unprecedented moment, a once-in-a-century experience, without awareness or preparation. Yet, here you are, graduating and beginning your newest and biggest endeavor in your adult life. You are becoming an adult, leaving your parents, siblings, family members, friends, associates, teachers, mentors, classmates, and other important figures in your life. The people who have carried you forward, supported your dreams, and been on this journey with you through your high school voyage. It can be a little scary and a very foreign pursuit without parameters or barriers on who you can become or what you will experience firsthand. Now that I've pleased Dr. Brockington and the rest of the Creative Arts staff, let's get to the real tea. The next phase of your life is real, and I do mean real. Realize more than 55 days since the Don't Rush Challenge. Realize 270 days since the Rihanna Fenty Beauty Runway Show. Realize 437 days since the first Black woman to headline Coachella. Realize 1,379 days since Colin Kaepernick took a knee. Realize 2,241 days of Flint, Michigan still not having clean water. Realize 4,526 days since we inaugurated President Barack Obama. And realize 146,400 days since the first Black people were brought across the Atlantic in shackles. Life is real. And while a lot of commencement speeches this year say how we can get through this, and how amazing it is that you have gotten through it against all odds. Though that may be true, I want to keep it a buck with you. It's no easy road. Many jobs have disappeared, and we have endured a global pandemic that has reshaped total industries. I'm speaking to you today as a Broadway performer who does not know when I will ever be returning back to work. Entertainment, commercial real estate, travel, hospitality, the food industry, all completely upended with no clear understanding of where they will go next. I want you to know that I see you, especially as a Black man in America, the amount of endless work each of you are going to have to put in to make this happen. And while some of you may experience self-doubt or fear, I want you to know that we are all in this fight with you. We trust and believe in the brilliance you possess and have achieved thus far, mainly because I recognize that now more than ever, you are the generation that will literally shape what our new normal should be. Not only because of the global pandemic or from a social justice point of view, your generation has the ability to rewrite history and create a world that not only looks like you, but feels and exists in the ways in which you believe. You all are our future leaders, doctors, legislators, creatives, producers, educators, entrepreneurs, and the list goes on. My class advisor, Timothy Jenkins, with the big head, taught us, the will to succeed is useless unless you have the will to prepare. And you all are more than prepared to fulfill your dreams and make us beyond proud of what you can become. It is with the sincerest love and well wishes to the graduating class of 2020 from the Creative Arts Morgan Village Academy. Be well and Godspeed.
How do I say goodbye to what we had? see forever, but forever's gone away. It's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday. I don't know where this road is going to lead. All I know is where we've been and what we've been through. And if we get to see tomorrow, hope it's worth all the way. It's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday. And I'll take with me the memories to be my sunshine. Say goodbye to yesterday. And I'll take with me the memories to be my sunshine after the hard to say goodbye to yesterday. Love you guys.
Hi, class of 2020. It's me, Miss Shakir. I need you to know that we are also very proud of you. You are our proof of what resilience, strength, courage, and dedication really looks like. Remember to stand firm and proud when representing for our city. Be proud of who you are and not ashamed of how someone else sees you. Believe in yourself, push your limits, experience life, conquer your goals, and most of all, be happy. We wish you all so much success in your current and future endeavors. We love you. And now, the moment you've all been waiting for, beginning with our valedictorian and salutatorian. Lanesia Robinson. Imani Bennett. Abiel Perez. Jamai Washington. Pedro Rodriguez. Shanti Hornsby. Bria McNeil. Sanaya Dorsey. Davion Harper. Deja Holloman. Deliana Hernandez. Edgar Rugama. Saya Dawson. Janaya Milton. Janari Oquendo. Ayesha McCray. Isaiah Davis. Jatayamo L. Lewis. Jose Velez. Caleb Mackin.
Jose Oliveras. Kalima McMichael. Kaylee Gomez. Kiara Chaplin. Crystal Nieves. LaQuaya Sellers. LaShira Roberts Moore. Maria Taneo. Michael McLean. Milagros Lovett. Natalia Delgado. Diana Mateus. Philip Funches. Quenaz Adams. Quamir Turner. Ruben Zayas. Sapphire Alvarado. Shantina Dallas. Shanice Smith. Tanaya Thornton. Tian Smith. Tochi Chukwacha. Tajmir Cordy. Trayana Fang. Tersana Grant. Tyson Broken Barrel. Vashawn Roberts. Zainab Hall. Zakira Hawkins. Zaria Bird. Thomas Creighton. Christopher Naranjo.
Graduates, please stand. By the power vested in me as the State District Superintendent for the Camden City School District, I hereby affirm that the senior class of 2020 has met the graduation requirements on this day as set forth by the New Jersey Department of Education. To the graduating class, I hereby confer upon you high school diplomas with all rights and privileges thereunto appertaining. At this time, please move your tassels from right to left, signifying the completion of your high school career. Congratulations and best wishes on future success.